Welcome to our tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to give a presentation with SlideLizard. To follow this tutorial, you have to connect your presentation with SlideLizard first. If you haven't linked it already, check out our tutorial video on how to activate SlideLizard for your presentation. After that, go to the SlideLizard tab in PowerPoint. Make sure that your slides are complete and up to date before you continue. You can see here if your slides are synced. If they are not, just click on the icon and your changes will be updated. Now click on Start Presentation. If your slides aren't up to date, you will get a warning here as well. Just click on Update Slides and they will be updated for you. You can decide whether you want to allow your audience to ask questions or not, and if you want to receive feedback. The last option allows you to share the location of your presentation with your audience. After you selected everything to your preference, click on Start Presentation. The SlideLizard Presenter view opens, which is, except for some additional options, quite similar to the one you're used to from PowerPoint. On the bottom left, you can find your participation link, which your attendees need to connect to your presentation. Whenever you hover it, you can also see the password you've set for the presentation. If you want to show the link to your audience, just click on Show Participation Link. Your attendees then can either scan your QR code or they enter the whole link in the address bar of the browser of their choice to get connected. To hide the link again, just click once more. Next to the link, you can see how many people are currently participating in your presentation. This is also displayed in the presentation report afterwards. If you have prepared any polls for your presentation, you can find them here. Just click on Start and your attendees will be able to vote. If you want to show the results of your poll to your audience, click on Show Results to Attendees and the chart will be shown in your presentation. To close the voting, press Finish. You can always reopen questions in case some people weren't fast enough to answer. Here you can create spontaneous quick polls. The process is the same as for preparing a poll beforehand. During your presentation, people in the audience will have the opportunity to ask questions via SlideLizard. It's up to them if they choose to log in or ask anonymously. However, if they are logged in, you have the possibility to answer their questions via email even after the presentation has finished. When a new question arrives, you will be notified here. If you want to answer a question, just click on it and it will be shown for everyone. After you answer the question, it will be marked so you can concentrate on the unanswered questions. When you close the presenter view, you can choose to either pause or finish the presentation. Pausing is recommended if you want to show your audience something in between, like a video or so. Your attendees will still be able to ask questions meanwhile. In case you are at the end of your presentation, choose Finish. Asking questions won't be possible anymore, and if you start a presentation with the same slides again, you'll get a new participation link. Everything will be set anew again, so you get a separate set of data at the end. Thanks for watching. In the next video, I will show you how to analyze your performance using the SlideLizard presentation report.